Hello, everyone. Coming to you live from the backyard. Yo. Hi, everybody. Boom, 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 boom. What is this pimple I have on my nose? Hi, everybody. I just wanted to log on and say hi, and hi, Rodney. I just wanted to point out the big announcement that I made last night. So, for those of you who haven't checked yet, on October 29th, Friday night, I'm going to be doing a live stream of my Vegas show. It's going to be out there for 2 weekends in person in Vegas, and I know a lot of you guys can't make it over to the U.S., my international fans, and even some of you here in the U.S. that can't make it to Vegas, so I thought, let's live stream that thing. So that's what we're doing. Oh my god, this filter makes my teeth look green. How exciting. So I want you guys to come check it out if you can. And it's going to be a Halloween vibe because it's October and it's my favorite holiday and might as well get festive. So I'm going to be putting songs in the set that are nice surprises, switching some stuff up, pulling out some old ones. You know, I want it to be a really fun new show for you guys. So please check it out. The tickets are on sale now. All the information is here on the Instagram. I'm really excited. And, you know, because it's a themed show, I put together some new merch with my team, and that is up on my store now. There's some fun stuff. So check that out. What else? Oh, and we added a 6th show to that run in Vegas, which is on the 20th. So now I'm doing 6 shows. I'm excited. I want you guys to come check it out. Or get tickets to this live stream. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm excited. I don't have much else to say. I keep thinking about like ideas for the show and also what the fuck am I gonna wear? I don't know yet. I'm excited. I can't wait to put it all together. I have 2 months. Or 1.5. Anybody have any questions? What else is going on? What's everybody doing? What? Yeah, I know. My teeth look green because of this filter. It's weird. Oh, now they look okay. Weird, huh? Hi, Spain. Any ideas on what you're going to be for Halloween? Nah, I haven't figured it out yet. Exactly. But that's the fun thing about this show is that I have an opportunity to dress up 6 different times, and maybe I'll just look different every time. I don't know yet. I haven't decided. Maybe not. I don't know. What time is it over here? It is about 1 in the afternoon. Yeah, the UK is getting back to normal. That's good. Possible concerts on the East Coast? No, just for now. We're just doing Vegas for now. That's what it is. Hi from the UK. Toronto. Thanks for saying hi, everybody. But also, what's going on? What's new? Ask me some questions. Potatoes have skin. I have skin. Therefore, I'm a potato. That is the most interesting message I've gotten on this whole live stream. I like that. Happy birthday, Christina. Will Queen make a cameo in Vegas? No. I mean, I'll definitely be doing some Queen songs. But Brian and Roger, you know, they can't actually come to the U.S. right now. No one can as a tourist. Still here in the U.S., which is getting a little strange, considering that we can prove vaccinations and tests and all that stuff. I find it weird that our borders are still closed. I don't really get it. It seems to me like no one just wants to take the time and energy to screen people. Are we being lazy and cheap? Maybe. Who was your idol growing up? Oh, man. I mean, I remember being a kid and really loving Madonna. She was pretty badass. Have you any new ideas for your own music? I've been working on a new album, for sure. It's a slower process because it is a concept album. It's a musical. So that will be coming out probably next year. Stay tuned. Missed your voice singing. Aw. Well, get a ticket to that live stream and you can hear me sing for the whole thing. Seriously, I can't wait. I think it's gonna be so cool to do a show that feels different, you know what I mean? When does your show start? Do you mean like the time at night? I'm guessing it'll be around 8 p.m. I need to double check on that. And I realize that some of you internationally, it's going to be weird hours to watch it. There was no other way to do it live than to do it live. So I apologize. I wish there was some sort of system where we could air it at a normal showtime for you, but we don't have that option. Hi, Brenna. Anybody have any questions for me? How many pairs of boots do you have? Oof, I should count. There's a lot of boots in there. I have like a shoe closet. I had fun last night. I posted a TikTok, and I'm not really that well-versed in making, you know, edited TikToks. It was complicated. I don't have that much practice with that thing. It took me longer than it probably should have, but I had fun. Are you going to be watching the VMAs this year? Yeah, I'll definitely take a look at that. How big is your staff for Vegas? I mean, you're not alone on stage. My staff? My band? We have 4 band members, like usual. Yeah, and then there's some crew backstage. And we're gonna be doing all sorts of like safeguards to make sure everybody's very safe with COVID testing and whatnot. Yeah. Can you smell the smoke from the fires? What fires? Maybe I'm out of the loop. Are there fires? How about a makeup tutorial for Halloween? Good idea. Oh, the Val Kilmer documentary. You know what? It's on my list. I need to watch that. I really do want to watch that. What's the Vegas tea? Can we go? Of course, just text me. Duh. Did you get vaccinated? Yeah. I got vaccinated as soon as I fucking could. Looking forward to watching you on Clash of the Cover Bands. Yeah, that airs on E! On the 13th of October. Very excited about that. I had so much fun. You gotta tune in. It's like a party. Is Terrence doing backup singing in Vegas? No, because Terrence is in the LA production of Hamilton at the Pantages Theater. And they just reopened. They were supposed to open right before all the COVID stuff got shut everything down. So he's been sort of in a holding pattern. But yeah, go see Hamilton in LA. See Terrence on stage. Any new songs for Vegas? Yeah. There's some surprises in there. I haven't totally solidified exactly what I'm doing, but I have a bunch of ideas and I want to work through them all. How many shows is Clash of the Cover Bands? Is it 10? Maybe 10? I don't remember exactly the number. Something around 10. Yeah, and Starstruck in the UK, that should be airing next year, I think. We don't have a solid date yet, but soon. Rock in Rio. I would love to come back and play Rock in Rio. I loved it. Please sing a lot of music from Velvet. There will definitely be a Velvet song for sure. Can I just relax with you? I mean, that's what I'm doing. You and Maroon 5 ever make a song together? I don't know. It's random. No plans, too. Have you tried sound healing, yoga? I've done yoga. I actually kind of want to get back into it. I've never done the sound bath thing. I've heard really cool things about it. I'd like to give it a shot. Favorite scary movie? I really liked Hereditary. I thought that was super trippy. And I love Toni Collette, the actress in it, so that was partial to that. Midsommar was really good too. I like that new director. I forget his name off the top of my head. Do both of them. Do you believe in past lives? I don't know. You know, it's like I want to believe in it because I feel like it makes sense on some poetic level, and I've definitely had a couple moments in my life where I've thought, well, that's resonating with me for no apparent reason. I wonder if it's past life. So I don't know. Does your hair just curl that way? What curl? There's no curl. What do you think about ABBA and their new music? Oh, I saw that they put something out. I need to listen to it. I didn't listen to it yet. Are you vegetarian or vegan? No, I am sort of a pescatarian right now. I'm eating fish. Sometimes I eat chicken. I'm not one thing strictly. I think I love vegan food because I think it's tasty. And I think that I firmly believe you do not need meat at every meal. I think you can do a lot of plant-based. Why the Ouija board for merch? Well, it's a Halloween show. And I thought it was a tongue-in-cheek kind of kitschy thing to put to do a Ouija board with my name on it. Connect to the spirit world with me on Halloween. I don't know. I just thought it was fun. Can you update us on your video game hobby? How's it going? What are you playing now? I'm still playing Assassin's Creed. I am doing Assassin's Creed Valhalla. And I just bought the just released expansion add-on thing. Some Battle in Paris thing. And I'm in the middle of that. It's fun. I love it. It's a nice escape from the world. Pharaoh's good. Pharaoh's right here.
Hey, buddy.
He likes to follow me around.
Hi, buddy.
Flexitarian, yes, that is sort of what it's called. But yeah, I do think that people need to consider not eating meat for every meal. It's not necessary. And I don't think it's like, from what I've read and actually from my personal experience, it's not like the best for your digestion either, you know? Obviously, it's great to have protein and iron and all that, but every meal? I don't know. And that's such an American thing. We have meat at every entree. I mean, I don't know. You have two blue fingers on the table in the window at home. What do they represent? Fingers? They're not fingers. They're heads. They're like profile in profile. They're two heads. They're like it looks like Greek, like an old Greek illustration or something of like a Caesar or something. Jonathan Adler. Great interior design company. I have a lot of his stuff. I love it. Hey, gorgeous. Have you ever done drag? Yeah, I mean, not like fully pro. I don't know if I've ever gotten like full drag. But yeah, I've definitely like put on a wig and a dress before. Back in the day, there was a club called, Drag Strip here in LA. It was like a night over in Silver Lake, I think. And everyone was encouraged to come and drag, which was really fun. And there were like contests. And so I came a couple times trying to win. And then once there was a party once, this is all so long ago, but there was a party in West Hollywood years ago. And my boyfriend and I at the time, we didn't have like much money between us. This is, you know, way before Idol and stuff. And there was a cash prize for outfits. It was like a disco thing. And so we dressed the hell up. We went for it and we won. And it was like $300, which at the time we were like, great, we're broke. Favorite song at the moment? We've been playing that Charlie XCX song, the new one that just came out. What's it called? Good something? Good. It's really good. It's a great beat. Check out Charlie XCX's new song. And the video is really cute, too. When is your next performance? I'm actually going to be doing Global Citizen. So stay tuned for details about that. That should be cool. Which vaccine did you take? I took the Pfizer vaccine. Although we didn't really have much of a choice. It was sort of like a random thing, like you get what you get kind of a thing, but happy to report that I received the Pfizer vaccine. Sorry if this has been asked. When will the details of the meet and greets be sent to those who purchased? I don't know the answer to that, but we will definitely be giving you info. Stay tuned. Recommended movies, series. I just watched a series called Brand New Cherry Flavor on, I think it was Netflix. And it was so trippy and weird and dark and funny. It's definitely worth watching. It's a funny show. Like dark humor, you know? I got the Pfizer because my grandmother didn't have much of a reaction, and gratefully neither did I. Yeah, I mean, you know, I'll just do a quick preach about the vaccines to those of you out there. I know that some people have legit medical conditions. Totally cool. It is your choice. But I just have a question for you. The probability of having a complication from this vaccine is way lower than having a complication of a serious case of COVID, especially now that Delta's running around. I realize neither one of them's a perfect choice, but I mean, wouldn't you take the like safer of the two? Wouldn't you want to protect yourself as opposed to not protect yourself? I don't know. I don't get it. I don't get why people aren't doing it. But I also I don't think that it's right to like bully people into doing it either. That's not very cool, because it is their choice. And truthfully, even though the more people we have unvaccinated, the longer it's going to take for this thing to go away, which is annoying. Truthfully, the people that aren't vaccinating themselves, they're the ones that are putting themselves at risk. So I wish them, or any of you out there, I'm thinking of you, I'm sending you good vibes. I hope you don't get that Delta. But why risk it? My husband wants me to get it. I'm super nervous. Yeah, but, yeah, I get it, but, you know, almost everybody that I know just felt like they had the flu for a day, and then it was fine, and the peace of mind is great. Not to politicize this, because I actually don't think that it should be political. I don't get why it's become political. I think it's just a health issue, you know. People should just be safe. It has nothing to do with what political party you're a part of or anything like that. Which was your favorite island from your vacation? I went to Aruba and Curacao with Oliver. We had so much fun. And Curacao, I think was my, I think I preferred Curacao just because it's a bit more Euro. It feels slightly less touristy to me. Also, I'm biased because the resort that we stayed at was called the Boaz. And it was stunning. It was like a really great resort. Aruba was nice, no complaints. We did a lot of like activities in Aruba, like water sports, and we rented ATVs, which was really fun. So yeah, I had fun in both places. It was hot down there. Would you ever go to Egypt? That is on the bucket list. I love Egypt. I want to see those pyramids. Is the original High coming back on vinyl? That's an interesting idea. Didn't think about it. But I will think about it now. Hi, Australia. Your favorite fashion designer? I have a few. Rick Owens is socking it to me lately. I mean, I was into Rick Owens years ago and then kind of like was into other stuff, and now like I feel like I've circled back to it. His stuff is really cool because it's glam, but it's also sort of like industrial. I like the like dichotomy of it all. And the high heels are dope. Have you ever been in Panama? Yeah, I was in Panama once. Leopard print or zebra? Ooh. I think I like leopard print better, but that, I mean, I'd love zebra too. McQueen? I haven't been wearing McQueen lately. I love their stuff, but to be totally honest, I can't fit into it. They don't make my size. I'm, you know, rocking a little bit of the dad bod these days. I'm a little huskier than I used to be, and, you know, makes fashion a bit challenging if it's not the right fit or cut. Yeah. So McQueen, I'll make my size, but Dolce & Gabbana is incredible. I love their stuff. It fits beautifully. Most of the lines fit beautifully. All right, guys. Well, this was a lovely chat. I've been on here for a minute. I love you all. A reminder, we have added a show in Vegas on October 20th. We are going to be live streaming the October 29th show, Friday, October 29th. Please check out the information here on my Instagram to buy a ticket for that. There's new merch on my website store. There's a website link here on my Instagram page as well. And I love you guys very much, and I want you to join in for this show. It's gonna be fun. All right, I love you. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.